let me start. So I'm Tosca, I'm a journalist and a dating expert. I became a dating expert by writing a book on dating, and it's all about male-female relationship and what scientists have discovered about why we think we are attracted to each other and why we are attracted to each other. And I was asked by my co-author to write a piece about dating because he was married for 10 years and he decided he could not think of anything to write on that subject, so he asked me because I was dating a lot, really, really a lot. I was on all the dating sites. I was on eMatching, RelatiePlanet, Lexa, OkCupid, but also on the more shady things. What's the one where you can cheat on your spouse? I forgot.
Second Love.
Second Love, yes. I was on that one as well, which was really entertaining, and I was single, which made it more fun for me, less fun for the men who were already in a relationship, but we're not here to talk about that. I'm here to talk about, to tell you why you should or should not be on a dating site, because there are a lot of reasons to be on a dating site. Normally it's to find love or sex or some kind of companionship, but I think dating sites are actually quite inefficient, and I will tell you why. Let's see. So from this 2.7 million people that are single, more than a million are on Dutch dating sites. We have, let's see, I wrote this down for you. Yeah, we have a few big ones in Holland. They're called Lexa and RelatiePlanet. And in between months, they vary between 300,000 and 600,000 active members. So on good days, let's say the month before Christmas, we have more or less 1.5 million users on those websites. And since a few years, we also have, we also have Tinder. I don't know who's on Tinder or who has heard from Tinder. Probably everybody. No? Nance? No? Okay, good. Tinder, well, Tinder is a lot of fun. As we all know, it's connected to our Facebooks, and it's a very easy way to meet new people. You just have a stack of pictures, and you either swipe left or right. Left if you don't like them, right if you do want them. And if they do the same, if you both like each other, you get a match, and you can chat, and you can meet up and do whatever you want. Well, that's a lot of fun, of course, and everybody thinks so. Tinder has 1.2 million active users in the Netherlands, and that amount is really, really growing. And if you think 1.2 million users is little, it's 7% of Dutch people. I think it's a staggering amount of people who are on Tinder. This is a newer research done by the Centraal Bureau for the Statistiek again, and they have been, they asked people who were in a steady relationship where they met. And they have been doing that since 1998, and you can, that's the yellowish, let's see, I had a light in here, didn't I? Woo! Oh. Could you go one back, please? So you see that overall, people meet each other when they go out in a bar, or they go on a holiday, or they recreate in some other form. Then the second way they meet most people is through friends, neighbors, and then they meet people through work, internet, school, a hobby or a sport or church, or through family. And as you can see, the internet, which is in the middle, from 1998 to 2003, very little people met over the internet. And as we proceed, you see that the internet part is actually growing. It's really growing fast, even faster than all the other things, because meeting people through going to a bar, it's actually demising. It's getting less and less since we're meeting more over the internet. I'll try to go to the next one now, because it has some, yes, some interesting information about the ages that people who have met each other over the internet from 2008 till 2013, they're actually seniors, they were quite old. Mm-hmm. And this is not the Tinder generation, this is people who were married before maybe, or were divorced, or maybe they or their spouse have died, and they started over, and they used the internet to find another significant other, that's a different word. So I thought that was really, that's fun, because it's, I thought the top part would be in 18 to 30 years old, but apparently it's the older people who have a lot of fun on the internet.
This is my all-time favorite. This is, I don't know this dude, but he gets married, I think, in the program. And he is now sniffing jars, with t-shirts in them. And you have seen in the little TED talk what it does. The smelly t-shirts of the lady slept in them for 3 nights, and he's smelling the jars. And then the first 3 jars he opens, he's like, this is disgusting. And then he opens the 4th one, and he's like, not that bad. Which is funny, because we all know a t-shirt you have slept in for 3 nights is not really Robijn fresh. It's just, nah. But he liked this shirt. And he was matched with the girl from this shirt. And, well, they got married. And I need to figure out how this went. So I will try to tell you what's going on there. Oh, we're at the end. Fun. The conclusions. Well, dating sites, according to me, and apparently I'm an expert, are not the most effective way to find potential partners. And I think you should see a dating site as a bar next door. You can go there, meet people you otherwise would not meet, do your first selection, because I don't know about you, but I sometimes go for people who are already in a relationship when I'm at a bar, or I always go, I don't know. Sometimes it's better to just make your selection before you approach somebody, and you can easily do that on dating sites. So dating sites are a good way to get to know people you wouldn't have approached otherwise. And then just hunting, meeting people, talking up to people, offering people drinks in a bar, at a bus stops, in a college classroom, it's so much more effective than being on a dating site. So if you are trying to meet people on a dating site, please keep the communication to a minimum. Just try to establish that he or she is not a freak. And go out for a cup of coffee in public. Please, in public. Never at home. In public. Dating sites could match more accurately by using more technology. And some of this technology is already available. I don't know if you know the Dutch dating website Pepper, which is a very small initiative still. They give you the option to include a video message. And what a video message says like a million more things about you than just a picture. Because you can hear a voice, you can see the mimic in somebody's face, you can even see how somebody holds himself, how confident he or she is. And it would be so great if we could just have that in all our freaking dating sites, because it would just make everything so much easier. And then you have this iris scan technology. And wouldn't it be fun if that was to be included on Tinder? Because you have to swipe through that whole stack of pictures. But if your webcam was looking into your eye, and if it saw that you were attracted to someone, and maybe you would give him a red cross, but the computer would say, no, you really like each other. And then you would have a match. I'd really like if that would happen. And I think we can. And then the latest point of my conclusion is dating sites that tell you that they can find the one for you by using their magic algorithm, they're lying. All of them.